Hello students, welcome to our today's class. In the today's class we are going to focus on very important topic with this question. In this question they are asking about which of the four molecules, okay, in these four molecules which molecule has not having equal bond lengths, okay, or equal types of bonds. Now if you take first example, you all know very well that NF3 is a pyramidal structure. It has nitrogen has one lone pair on its head, so obviously all bonds are in equal mode, we don't have any problem with this. Now coming to the ClF3, if you take its hybridization, its hybridization is sp3d, and you can calculate this hybridization with this model. I have explained same trick in our channel, you can refer that. And next, if you coming to the geometry wise, you can take it as like a T shape, okay, and here two lone pairs are occupying an equatorial position. I will explain in detail manner about ClF3. Now we will check about that option C and option D. Option C, if you take BF3 is nothing but a sp2 hybridization. It is having square trigonal planar, it's not square, trigonal planar, you can take it like that. Now same manner ALF3 also having trigonal planar, so there is no lone pair in this last two molecules, or BF3 and ALF3, but only that lone pairs you can see in the first one, but that lone pair is not affecting on the bond lengths. But whereas coming to the ClF3, if these lone pairs are affecting the bond length of this molecule, how we need to go and we need to see that the major point here. Therefore here lone pairs, if you take into the one equatorial position, two equatorial positions are occupied by the two lone pairs, then its structure turned to the trigonal bipyramidal. If you observe here, this lone pair is 90 degrees towards this fluorine and 120 degrees towards this fluorine. So these center fluorines are called as axial bonded fluorines, and this fluorine is called as equatorial fluorine. So here these axial fluorines are getting more effect, this axial bond is affected by this lone pair. Due to this repulsion, this axial bond length is little bit higher than the bond length in between chlorine and equatorial fluorine. So therefore this molecule is having unequal bonds, the bond lengths are not equal, unequal bonds are there. So we can say like that, confidently we can give that answer for this. Not only in this molecule, same manner you can check in the PCl5 also. In the PCl5, if you take, I think you know very well about that PCl5. PCl5 structure is what? Trigonal bipyramidal. So if you take a trigonal bipyramidal, that axial chlorine's bond length is very high when compared to the equatorial bond lengths, because of here all three chlorines repel those what? Axial chlorines. That's why axial chlorines bond length is higher than the equatorial three chlorines. So we can explain like that. Not only that, we can take SF4 and SF6 also. If you take SF6 here, in the SF6 what's going on in SF6, all fluorine sulfur bonds, bond angles are 90 degrees only. As I told you, PCl5, if you take in the PCl5, bond lengths are, bond angles are different, and automatically bond lengths also different. But here in SF6, if you take all bond angles, what, same, and bond lengths also same. But SF4, if you take, unequal bond lengths are there. If you take SF4, in the SF4, what is going on here? SF4 structure is seesaw shape, and it is having one lone pair. If you draw its structure like trigonal bipyramidal structure, if you draw like that, here one equatorial position is occupied by the lone pair. This lone pair here 90 degrees to the axial fluorine and 120 degrees to the equatorial fluorine. So obviously you know very well 90 degrees containing bond angle containing axial fluorine is more affected by this lone pair, the obviously here bond length will be increased. So this is the major point here. We can understand this concept like this. Here you see that bond angle of here axial SFA bond length is more due to the repulsion. Whereas if you take SF6, we already discussed about SF6. If you take SF6, all bond angles in SF6 90 degrees only, in between two, any two if you take 90 degrees only bond angle, there is no change in the bond angle, automatically repulsions are all equal in all directions, therefore there is no change in the bond length of the what SF in SF6. But whereas if you take PCl5, in the PCl5 bond angles are different. In equatorial position bond angles are what 120, and in axial position bond angles are 90 degrees. That's why in PCl5 the axial bond length is higher than the equatorial bond length. This is very useful concept for inorganic chemistry. This is about our today's class. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.